Hey guys, Ivan here, and we have a physique update of Rolly Winkler 1 month after the Mr. Olympia. This was at the Josh Narkowitz Classic, down under in Australia, of course, and I have to thank my friend Xavier Willis from Desktop Bodybuilding for filming this video. So guys, I mean, this is nothing really we haven't seen before. We've seen Rolly posing in his guest posings many times, and in the gym, in the mirrors, and so on. And he always looks huge, he always looks impressive, so I don't know, I mean, this is really nothing new, but yeah, it's a new video, so enjoy it. I mean, I would really like to see this in person. I'm sure my mind will be blown, but really, as far as him being better bodybuilder, competitive bodybuilder, you know, winning the Mr. Olympia or doing something like that, this really doesn't help us make any kind of conclusions, really, because the size is not the problem for him. He was the biggest guy at Mr. Olympia. It's always conditioning. It's always conditioning, especially with this guy, because he's so huge. If he got crispy, if he got sharp, well, I guess if he added some mass to that back, too, he would be unstoppable. But still, even like this, he would win the Mr. Olympia if he was sharp, because he was the most complete bodybuilder and the biggest one, the most freaky looking and so on, but he was not conditioned, he was off with conditioning. But he is the Beast, that's his nickname, and he definitely represents that nickname very well, because he's a freak. When will we see him compete again? I have no idea. He didn't say anything about it, he didn't announce anything. He is qualified for the next Mr. Olympia, because he was 5th this year, but I'm assuming since he doesn't have his own supplement line, he doesn't have much of a business going on, he's not a coach, he's just being a bodybuilder. That's his job, that's his profession. He's doing competitions, he's doing these kind of guest poses, and so on, he's traveling, he's being a bodybuilder full time, and he has a great sponsor. And who the hell knows what is in that contract, but I'm sure sponsors would not be happy having a bodybuilder who competes only once a year. And he doesn't even win the Mr. Olympia, so he probably needs to compete several times. So I'm sure we're gonna see him early next year, maybe Darren Classic, maybe a couple of shows next year, probably a couple of shows. Many guest posings, I'm sure. And Rolly is known for not prepping for too long. I mean, it shows on his conditioning as well, but he just doesn't like doing it too long, I believe. I think he's just happy for being one of the best bodybuilders in the world, by being people's champion, by having sponsors, and by living a life that he enjoys, and he's happy with it. I don't think he cares too much about being Mr. Olympia. So I'm sure we're gonna see him compete next year very soon. Probably sooner than we expect, and as soon as it happens, I'm gonna make a video about it, so guys, stay tuned, subscribe! So, if Rolly wanted to win the Mr. Olympia, he would have to take it away from this man right here, the 2019 Mr. Olympia winner, of course, Brandon Curry, who just posted this photo, right here. Of course, I had him winning the Mr. Olympia way before the Mr. Olympia even started. I predicted him winning that Sando, and I would give it to him again. But some people didn't really like this outcome, some had Harry Choppen placing ahead of him. But I think Brandon deserved it. I don't want to analyze it again because he already made a video about this, but I just want to say he was the most complete guy in that stage. Now, having that said, he deserved 2019 Mr. Olympia, but he is definitely not one of the best Mr. Olympias ever. He is actually, on the contrary, one of the worst Mr. Olympias of all time. And that's the truth. That's the truth. He's one of the worst. He's not complete. And the only reason why I'm saying this is because of his legs. His conditioning can be sometimes better, sometimes worse, and he can improve that easily, but his legs is something he's struggling with. Will he get them ever to match his upper body? I don't think that's ever gonna happen, but will he improve them? I have no doubts, because he improves himself every year, and now being the Mr. Olympia defending champion, he has more motivation than ever, I'm sure. If he really wants to secure that title, he needs to train harder. I mean, Ronnie Coleman trained harder year after year, even after winning that 1998 Mr. Olympia so easily, so decisively. He never stopped trying to get better and better, and that's why he is the greatest of all time. And if Brandon plans to get near to Ronnie's level, he will need to improve a lot. He can't stop right now, he needs to try harder and harder and harder. Anyway, this is his photo that he uploaded today. But it's not a recent photo, it's from his Mr. Olympia 2019 prep files, and I would say he was sharper at this photo right here than he looked at the Mr. Olympia. He got a little bit watery at the Mr. Olympia, so I think if he showed up like this, he would look much better. I think his conditioning here was better, he looked sharper. So next year, he better bring that conditioning up to another level, and he better bring those legs up, Because if this guy shows up, it's gonna be lights out for Brandon. Oh yeah, we have a new physique update of Phil Heath, and this time, finally, he shows his stomach. So we haven't seen this in a long time, and I made my comments on this in my previous videos. I said we saw his arms, we saw his chest, his back, pretty much everything, but we didn't see his legs and his abs, and now we can see them both. And as you can see, his legs are looking huge. That inner part, the adductor, is looking so massive. His legs are definitely on point, calves as well. Downstairs, he is huge, and if you take a look at his stomach, I don't know, I mean, he's hiding it a little bit with his hand, a little bit with his shirt, and the shadow is also falling on it, so you can't really see his stomach properly, but in this pose, in this shot right here, it doesn't look bad at all. It looks good. And that was the biggest critique that he received at the 2018 Mr. Olympia, where he lost his sandal finally, after 7 years in a row. That was the only reason, the freaking stomach. So if he decides to compete again, that's the only thing that he needs to improve. Everything else is just spot on, he is as muscular as anybody needs to be to win the Mr. Olympia. He just needs to come with better stomach. He can get conditioned, that's not a problem, he comes full, he comes big, he's complete, muscularity wise, all he needs is a proper midsection. Now, based on this photo, we can't really conclude much, but it's not popping, it's looking better, and it sends us a little bit of a message. Maybe he became aware of the problem, finally. Maybe he realized that he needs to work on fixing it. He needs to work on controlling that midsection better. And acknowledging that you actually have a problem, admitting it to yourself, is the first step in self-improvement, in fixing the problem. So if he realized that, just like an addict, an alcoholic, if he realized that he has a problem, he very well may even fix it, and I would really love to see that. I'm a huge fan of Phil Heath, especially on his prime years, 2011, 2012, 2013, 2016 was also good, even before the 2008, 2010. So if he came the way he looked in any of those years, you know, with much better looking stomach, with controllable midsection, he will be unstoppable. Nobody can stop him, nobody. Phil Heath with a good midsection is basically unstoppable. The only guy in the history who could stop him is Ronnie Coleman because of his wider back, and that's it. Phil Heath would be unstoppable if he did that, and I don't know if he's gonna compete. If you check my previous videos, you may conclude he's actually not gonna compete, but we'll see. We'll see. I mean, I don't know. I don't know. He didn't announce anything officially. If he does, I'm gonna be the first one to report it. So once again, guys, subscribe to my channel. Talking about the future competitions, if you guys didn't watch the new episode of Muscular Development Global Muscle Radio, you don't really have to watch the whole thing, you just go to second minute and you will hear them saying that Sean Roden and Big Ramy confirmed competing at the Arnold Classic 2020. So if this guy said it, it's probably very official because they have connections, they know people. I'm sure they got that from a reliable source, and whenever they say something, it comes to be true. So I believe them. I don't really like them, their personalities as much, but I must admit that they are very accurate and they are doing a great job with their channel. I mean, this is muscular development we are speaking of. So Rolly Winkler and Big Ramy confirmed it. And if all goes well, if none of them gets injured, if Sean doesn't go to prison, we're gonna see two of the best, one of the best bodybuilders in the world collide against each other. The one representing aesthetics in bodybuilding, that being Sean Roden, and the other one representing the mass, one of the biggest bodybuilders of all time, Big Ramy. That's gonna be an interesting battle, and I would have Sean Roden winning it 10 out of 10 times. Why? Because Big Ramy cannot get conditioned. And even if he gets conditioned, will he be deeply separated as Sean? I just don't see it. I just don't see it at this point. It's cool being optimistic, but at one point you just need to give up. And I just give up on Big Ramy. I don't think he will ever be conditioned the way he needs to be. Maybe, maybe, but that's a huge maybe. And based on their previous performance, Sean Roden will be taking that Arnold Classic title home very easily. Of course, assuming he comes in shape. In 2017, he wasn't in shape, and that's when Big Ramy actually beat him. But Sean brought his physique to a next level in 2018, so I'm expecting somewhat of the same package again. So if that happens, if these guys are both on, I will have Sean winning it. Just not assuming either one of them comes off, of course. If you guys follow my channel, you may have watched the video where I talked about Colin Montgomery. I noticed him posting some training videos in which he trained very hard, and I assumed he may be competing very soon. So I asked him and he told me he's gonna be competing in Japan Pro, and it's gonna happen in a couple of weeks from now. So this is his most recent physique update. He got his old size back. It is not much of an improvement from the last time we saw him compete. It's pretty much the same Cody. He just got back to his previous form. Will he be trying to advance after this show? Will he try to grow even furthermore? I would love to see that. I would really love to see that. I think it's necessary if he wants to be very good, you know, pro. If he wants to be at the Mr. Olympia or something like that. But like this, I don't know who else is competing in this Japan Pro, but this is not really Mr. Olympia worthy physique. He's still too small. He needs to grow a little bit more. And he's a young guy, really. He's only 1 year older than me, so he's like 25 right now. And for that age, he's looking very impressive. And I'm sure when the time comes, when he's like 30 or something, he will be much, much better. But as far as his genetics, the shape, the proportions, the lines, he's not exactly ideal, but he's good enough. So I'm sure we're gonna see him at the Mr. Olympia at one point. I'm just not sure when. Is it gonna be this year? I don't know. I don't know who else is competing at the Japan Pro, but he may just end up winning it. We'll see. We'll see. However, before the Japan Pro, we're gonna watch Regan Grimes competing at the Romania Pro, a Mr. Olympia qualifier, and if he wins it, he's gonna be at the Mr. Olympia in the Open. And I do not know who else is competing, but I'm sure many of the guys from the Mr. Olympia are just still trying to stay in shape and try to qualify for the Mr. Olympia. Lukas Osladil is not gonna be there. Hey, this guy competed so many times 2019, but he said that Fit Parade was his last show. So who is Regan going to compete against? I do not know. And will he be able to win it? Well, it's possible. He gained a lot of size. Look at him. Look how big this guy is. Only 2 years older than me, and he really kills my motivation. Sometimes I think like, well, if I just keep training hard and eating big and so on, if I just try to grow a little bit every year, maybe I will be as big as him. My back needs years to grow, but when I look at his physique and only 26 years of age, I just lose motivation. I don't think it will ever happen because this guy is only 26, only 2 years older than me, and he's much, much bigger because he is Mr. Genetics. I train 10 times harder than this guy, trust me. I watch him train and he trains so light. He just pumps the muscle. He does this high rep type of stuff. He never goes to failure, let alone beyond failure. And he grows. He grows like crazy. So this is genetics, guys. This is the ultimate bodybuilding genetics. Jay Cutler has been saying for a while that he's going to be the next Mr. Olympia. And I can see that. I can see that. He has the potential to grow so much muscle so fast by not even trying too hard. So imagine him when he's 35, now he's 26, imagine that, he's gonna be a beast, he's gonna be a force to be reckoned with. So let's wait, let's see what happens first at the Romania Pro, hopefully we're gonna see him at the Mr. Olympia next year, and hopefully he'll be one of the top guys in like 5 years or so. Anyways, thank you very much guys for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please like the video, and if you want to see more this kind of bodybuilding videos, subscribe to my channel. All the best, guys. Bye-bye.